Alrighty guys, so here we have our salt and our sugar, and I'm gonna go ahead and add in our pill bugs. I have pre-moistened both sides, so both sides have had some moisture on them. And I'm gonna get our little pill bugs. I'm gonna start them in this close, as close to the center as I can get them. Come here, oh no. For our lab. Oh, isopods. We'll see where they go. Let's see if I have any more hiding. Hope I got one. Nope, I got a couple. Good little isopod.
Do you have the big container?
I do.
Oh, I see the big.
It's hiding, but I do.
So the acid base, they're only 1%. So it won't hurt them, but.
They do like to wiggle around.
They do. Alright, I think that's all of them. Cool.
There we go.
Alright. So you did purple and red. Okay, I remember.
Oh yeah,
correctly.
That's well, I stole Allison's, so.
Oh.
Purple.
I couldn't remember. I'm like, I think I grabbed purple and red, like a cool color and a warm color.
You did.
Alrighty.
They really should. So behind.
Welcome back. So, little flower beetles, and we had one group that wanted to study the effect of a temperature. So they had a choice chamber where they had cold on one side and hot on the other. And then they put the little flower beetles in the middle, and every flower beetle that went to the cold side, all of a sudden they just went and they kind of fell over and were like this. They looked like they were dead, and they were all tensed up. They weren't dead, so don't worry, no animals were harmed. But they kind of froze. It was so cold. Now, at the end of the day, the numeric data all stated, you know, that they all ended up on the cold side. And so if you just looked at the numbers, it looked like they had a preference for cold. But if you also take into account science, and they really couldn't be more wrong. We will be using...
Yeah, I think that's what it is.
Math in this class quite a lot. And before a scientific research paper, you know, it's a really good way of communicating data. And an option is that a theory is a guess. It is not a guess. And we don't guess in science at all. And you might say, what about a hypothesis? Mrs. Robson. Well, a hypothesis is still educated, right? It's based on a test. What law describes what's happening? And I said this before, I'm gonna say it again. If it's content that's in a PowerPoint or that we've presented in a video or we've done labs on it or classwork, it will, I promise you, will be on the test. And you actually do need to study for exams in this class.